Hey friends, welcome. I'm here with my good friend and client, Kevin. And we recently, well, not so recently, I guess, bought a house with laneway potential. And really what I wanted Kevin to do is talk about that experience because we went through a lot just to get the house and you've been through a lot.
We sure did.
Renovating the house, so we'll walk through that experience. And really like keep it real for people, right? Because, you know, what I tell people is this isn't easy all the time and, you know you've had some sleepless nights.
Certainly. So, but I'm still smiling.
And you're still smiling.
I'm still smiling.
That's just who you are though, Kevin. That's just who you are.
Glass half full.
So let's talk about the search. And I remember we looked at a place on Clinton. Yeah. And
that's a nice one, though.
That was nice.
That was a nice house.
It was a good development opportunity. Yeah. But it didn't qualify for laneway.
At the time.
It does now because the rules changed. And then we drove by this house. And then I was like, because Tim actually said it didn't qualify at first. I don't know if you remember that.
I do remember that one. Yeah, I do.
And then we drove by and I was like, oh, this one looks good, actually. Tell me what you remember.
About the laneway potential. And so when we saw this one, it looked really nice. So we got excited, and I think we walked inside, and it actually was pretty finished. So, and well done.
It was pretty finished.
You'll see the inside in a moment. It was really finished. Had a nice kitchen, a nice bathroom, and we walked around, and Paul and I got very excited about it, and I think we went and saw some other houses, but this one kept coming back to the forefront.
I don't even remember now, but we did conditional on having a survey done, which, you know, these conditions are unheard of and they're a little bit complicated. So we had a condition on survey. Yeah, we had a financing condition
and survey condition. But the owner, I think, of the house back then, she was open to it. She didn't get any other offers, so I think we got a good deal there.
No, we got lucky. I don't know. Yeah, and now, like, this area's gone insane.
Yeah. So we got the conditional offer. Unfortunately, we couldn't get people to do the survey in time for us.
Key learning.
Plan ahead. But what Paul did is actually bring about the architect that I'm using, Creative Union, Tim, and they did the work for me here, and we couldn't get 100% confirmation, but with 99.9% assurances, this was with laneway potential, I accepted the offer based on your advice.
Well, and what had happened actually is the neighbor was going to build a laneway too. We didn't know that when we bought it, but they had just done a survey, so we could see the hash marks where the survey was, and that allowed us to be very comfortable that the distance was there that we were going to qualify.
Yeah, that's true. So originally the plan was move into the house, put a basement unit in there, and live in the house and have a lot of potential, but didn't quite work out that way.
And then we met with Tim.
Yeah, Tim and I guess his crew were measuring around, taking measurements and walking around. Didn't say very much. We're like, okay.
Yeah.
And then I remember heading back to Tim's office, pulled out the plans and his ideas, and we are where we are today because of Tim.
And so, the cool thing about what Tim proposed was not like one two-bedroom and a basement, but two 2-bedrooms, and both units have ground floor access. And so, when we did that, then, I was like, oh man, the numbers are going to be phenomenal on this property.
Yeah.
Right? Like when we get it rented, laneway, two 2-bedroom units. You're going to be crushing it. I know you're probably in the middle of stress right now, but he will be crushing it in the future.
Yeah.
Okay, so Kevin.
Mm-hmm. Yes, Paul.
Let's talk about the bill.
Let's talk about the bill.
I remember we had lunch at Benjara way before you even closed. We both like food. I think I mentioned that. And you said, Paul, what's going to mess up my timeline? And I said, honestly, Kevin, you're going to mess up your timeline.
This guy.
Because what the plan was to have all the drawings done, ready to go, so that when you close, boom, demo, start construction.
Correct.
So maybe I'll let you take over and explain what actually happened. And it's not to say you're a bad person or you screwed up. I'm just saying this is reality and this is what happens. And you have to, when you're buying a house, you have to be prepared for this. That's why I'm calling you out a little bit.
Yeah.
Sorry, Kevin.
I will take responsibility for that one. So the original plan was to just get it ready to have my family move in and then put like a little unit in the basement. But as Tim gave us new plans and I saw the vision, I sort of hemmed and hawed, and I wasn't sure if I wanted to just sort of, you know, do a fast job and just get it ready for rental, because there's just a lot of things that can go wrong if you have a buy and hold strategy. I kept the one functional kitchen and one functional bathroom, but I did do a full gut. When we put the addition on, I wanted even floors. I wanted a new heating system. I wanted state-of-the-art equipment for this time of, current modern equipment in the house.
Yeah.
Mechanical room. It just, to me, made for better sense. So I decided to basically gut the whole place, which was not part of the original plan. And so we are, I would say, 3/4 of the way through. Permit to change. Tim was quite accommodating with my change of strategy. And there's been a lot of pitfalls, a lot of learning along the way. But
I think a lot of sleepless nights.
A lot of sleepless nights. Yeah, it's not easy. It's definitely not easy. You have to have the vision always driving you.
Yeah.
You really do.
So let's talk a little. Let me just sort of jump in and say, you know, like, this is the right strategy. And I'm not sort of highlighting Kevin to say, don't do what Kevin did. Like, I actually think what you've done makes sense, because he's going to keep the property and knows it's solid. Nothing's going to go wrong. Yeah. And if something does go wrong, you know exactly how to fix it, because you basically rebuilt the whole house.
Paul took me through the property with some contractors, as well as Tim had a few contractors to suggest. So we had them walk through, they gave us some ideas. And then so I thought, you know, I'm going to learn the process. It might be a little bit harder the first time around, but I really want to learn the ins and outs and understanding how to go about it. And so I decided to be my own GC. I hired a contractor who would be on site here, and he has knowledge of a lot of the different things, but I would be the one administering the city stuff, dealing with the inspectors, and basically making decisions on the go. With the advice of Tim.
Sounds like a recipe for disaster.
I think the biggest learning curve is when you start to pull down walls of an old house, is you start to discover a lot of things that were never done right.
And you're saving yourself time and hassle later on too,
well,
right?
Yeah. So yeah. When you pull down all the walls, you might as well foam and insulate everything. So yeah,
you replumb
it,
rewire.
And you rewire it. So then you avoid electrical issues, you avoid plumbing issues, you save money on the heating as the years go by.
Yeah.
You know, we decided to transfer electrical into separate boxes so the tenant takes it on.
So that's a great plan.
And we are where we are today. The building's actually closed up. We've got stuccoed.
Right.
We got permission from the city to close up the walls now. And we're going to be able to start doing the fun stuff, which is actually the finishing, like the trim, the doors, installing the new kitchen, and installing the new bathroom.
It's going to get really sexy.
That's actually, you know, all the rest of the stuff you do is actually not sexy, but the bones of the house are technically the most important part.
Right.
Because you can always come back and redo a kitchen or a bathroom.
Yeah, or trim or paint.
But
that's the stuff you see, though. That's the problem.
That's the stuff you see. So I think.
What are the next steps? Like, what, you know? In your mind, how do we get this thing from here to rented?
A lot of blood, sweat, and tears. We're going to be plowing through the next couple of months.
Yeah.
The goal now is to hopefully have everything done in 2 months.
Yeah, great.
The cleaning touches, right? Make it look presentable.
Then I can take your pictures. I can virtually stage. We can get you great tenants.
I was going to say, then Paul is going to help me get some great tenants in here.
That's the plan. And then we can start to build the laneway.
Yeah, the laneway is next. I'm looking over towards it right now, but the laneway is next. That'll be hopefully a project for the spring. The nice thing, though, is that, you know, I bought the property almost a year ago. So I think for a year, minus all of my mistakes and the steep learning curve, Paul's been with me the entire time, and that, I have to say, It's been a blessing. Whenever I'm feeling down and out, I call Paul.
I cheer you up.
He cheers me up. Well, he answers the phone. Kevin. He cheers me up, and it really keeps me focused on what the prize is at the end of it all, and that I'm very thankful for.
And it's still a great plan, right?
Yeah. Like, oh yeah.
Like when you're done, you'll like a lot of this stuff you'll forget.
Yeah.
I mean, we'll talk about it and laugh about it.
Yeah. it's not my first time renovating a house.
No. It's,
and
yeah.
I think that's the hard thing is people when they don't realize it is that you know. This is probably my third big renovation. This is my biggest renovation, but the third time renovating a house.
Yeah.
It's always hard when you're thick of it all. And there are some there are some nights where you are panicking, stressed out. You're like, is this going to work out? But in the end, it does.
It does.
Because I think real estate is a really solid investment.
Yeah.
This is a great neighborhood.
Yeah.
And again,
this is a slam dunk.
Yeah. There's some beautiful parks in the area.
It's close to the subway. Yeah.
It's a winner. And I think if we were to look back, even with COVID, if we were to look back, this house has still appreciated in value.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
So much.
Yeah. And the bank hasn't even seen the addition yet.
Yeah.
And the two kitchens and the two bathrooms.
Cha-ching.
Cha-ching. Cha-ching.
So, I mean, you know, I like to ask people, I mean, I know we're friends, but, you know, that doesn't mean I'm necessarily a realtor of choice, but you know, maybe tell people like, you know, why you like working with us.
I have to say that you know, you were my realtor almost before we became friends.
Well, that's true. Yeah.
So I mean, you know, what drew me to you is when I met you is I felt there was an honesty there and a trust that right away was built into it, and that friendship actually grew. I think from the fact that you know, for that last year. You've been with me, you know, you got me introduced to Tim, some contractors, you put the idea of the laneway in my head, like, you know, it's all these things, I think is what led to the friendship, but mostly it's that trust and that confidence that I was well taken care of that led me to pick you as a real estate agent.
Thanks, Kevin. So that's a great point, Kevin, you know, and I like to talk about building a trusted team with clients who eventually become friends. So maybe just talk a little bit about what helped you, what helped build that trust with you and I?
I think when you're looking for a home, you get really excited about properties. And so I remember getting excited about a few properties and I was like, I like this one, Paul. And Paul's like, Kevin, this is not going to be the property for you. I'm like, "What? Why not, Paul? Why not? Look at all this." He's like, and then you were just listing off all the reasons why this wasn't going to work out. And I was like, oh, you know, and that means a lot because you kept me focused on the plan and you kept me focused on what I really was looking for.
Right.
And all those little things that potential sellers do to make their house look pretty and sellable, I think you saw right through and you're like, this is not what's going to work for you.
Well, and I guess, you know, the other thing we looked for is something that had great cash flow, something that was in a good neighborhood, easy to rent, and something that we talked about this today, that you can't overdevelop. This neighborhood, you can't overdevelop. All this stuff you're doing, like, you're not even close to the cap that you could sell for in this neighborhood, right? And those are and that's why I would say no to other places is, you know, you could dump 500 grand and then just be over renovated and not get your money out.
And not get my money out.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's very true. I remember you pulling out your little spreadsheet and every time we saw, every time we looked at a property, he'd be like punching numbers into it. And then, you know, that sort of like cash flow number would always appear. And he's like, this is a winner. This is not a winner. You know, appreciation. I think those are things that, you know, because this is the first house I buy with you.
Right.
I bought houses before.
Yeah.
I've never received that kind of service or that kind of attention from another realtor. And
Thanks, Kevin.
That really, that sold me on you, Paul.
Thanks, man.
Yeah, it really did. It really did.
Well, so I want to say thank you, Kevin. Yeah. I really appreciate you coming talking about this. I think it really helps people to understand, you know, this. Well, it sounds easy. And, you know, when I give you my spreadsheets, it makes it sound great. But the reality of it is you were shoveling things and right? So I appreciate you keeping it real.
Yeah, if you don't mind getting your hands dirty, it's great. I made that decision to do the work myself. You can easily, Paul has great contractors, a few of them on hand.
The sleepless nights, I don't know if I can promise to not deliver it.
Not deliver on.
Because there will be stress, right? There's financial stress, there's reno stress.
Yeah.
Especially if it's like, you've done it before, so it's a bit easier for you, but it could be very stressful, right?
Yeah, it could be very stressful. But like I said, I'm still smiling today. I'm excited. We're over the big hump. And that's what makes it a lot more exciting now.
And the money's gonna start rolling in. So thank you so much. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. Please like this video and please smash that subscribe button so you get updated every week when we give you a new video. And if you have any questions, if you want to talk about real estate, shoot me an email, paul@paulhaley.ca. Talk soon. Oh, you gotta do the thumbs up. No, thumbs up.
Ah.
Talk soon.
Thanks, Paul.
No, you gotta say, and yeah, action.
You don't have that, take one.
Just this house. I kinda wanna walk through that experience.
Do you want us to do it again
because
the baby was
yelling? Sure.
Okay.
I could've kept going. But you interrupted, Jared.
Baby's yelling, man.
Just edit that out. Am I in? Am I in the right angles?
All angles are good. Action.